covered over on the sideline by number 10, Goodrich. Goodrich was covering our outman, Mo Thompson, and he had him covered well. Incomplete second and 10.
Lebanon trying to run the up pattern, trying to get Mo on the sideline, isolated in man coverage. Ball overthrown, and good coverage by Goodrich, the defensive back for the Green Wave.
Gallatin in white and yellow britches, and Ledman in the blue and the white pants. Second and 10, and we run it up the middle this time, and we don't get a whole lot. We got three to the 44. We run our fullback again, and he got three. Dirksen's playing fullback tonight, and he's starting there, and he got three, and it's third and 7 on the 44. Gallatin already leading 7-0 as we're down to 4:56 first quarter on a beautiful night for football.
Jerry Joslin, who coaches the girls basketball team at Gallatin, is the defensive coordinator for the Green Wave. He calls those defensive signals.
Gallatin runs mostly a 50, and they stun out of it with a strong safety going to the slot. This time we're looking out here. We throw out here, incomplete, too high, incomplete, trying to hit Mo Thompson on about the 50. We were trying to hit him on an out. The pass was well covered again. Incomplete. Here comes Bo Grissom and his punting team to punt. Ball on the 44. We got a first down. And then we got bogged down. And now we're going to send Calvin Hall back to the 25 to catch this punt. They've got 9 men on the line like they're going to look up there and try to block it on us. 9 men coming hard. Here they come, and we got it away, and they roughed the kicker. They roughed the kicker. They didn't call it. They dropped the punt. It's a scramble for the ball. Who got it? I thought they roughed the kicker. We've got to wait and see. Did Lebanon get the fumble? Yes, we have recovered on a 33 for gift of roughing the kicker.
Michael Drake with the recovery, Bruce, as Hall dropped it. The official watching the play behind there ruled that Dawson blocked those two rushers into the punter, Bo Grissom. Hall muffs the punt, and Lebanon, a turnaround on field position. We've got the football in Gallatin territory.
Ball on a 33, first and 10. Triplett takes it, sweeps it outside. Maneer. Maneer on a 30, cut it in and got to the 25 and got 8. Zach Bonnier went from a 33 and got barely inside of a 25 and got knocked down. They'll actually put it on a 24. He got 8 yards on a sweep.
John Bryan, Michael Drake showing no ill effects from that cut hand last week, making that recovery.
No, Tommy, he's wide awake and he's going hard. And Skullrude, evidently, his growing pull is not bothering me, chasing that Gallatin quarterback down 60-some-odd yards in the early in the first quarter.
John, you'll check and see what Coach Medley's talking to the referee on this side about. Slot left, eye set, we're second and 2. Take the ball and we run a trap in the middle. I don't think we got it. We didn't get much of nothing. We got back to the 24, and we're 3rd and 2. We didn't get anything. They put it right on the 24 again, 3rd down and 2. We run Dirksen on the trap, but didn't get anything. Jody Inman's a linebacker. He calls the signals on defense. Gallatin right now lined up in a 50. Well, no, they jumped up in a 7-1 diamond. 7-1 diamond defense. Take it, and they run up the middle, and we don't get anything, and they knock us down. Tommy, they jumped up in almost an 8-man line. I know it was a 7-1. They had 3 deep. They had a middle linebacker, and they was expecting to run up the middle. They knock us down for a half a yard loss. We're 4th and 2.5.
Bruce, looks like the short yardage offense is coming onto the football field. Rose, Dirksen in there to block. Check it, Dirksen comes out. Kendall lines up at a tight end. So we've got two fullbacks, Marlowe C. and Rose. Zach Maneer got the
big
eye.
Play. We might try to draw him off sides. No, we run it. We jump, and I think he got it. Oh, me. Zach Bonnier took off like he was diving in space. First down, Blue Devil.
The
21-yard line. Did he fly through the air?
Bruce, he looked like Superman as he took off 4 yards deep, vaulting over the top of that Gallatin defense, falling for first down yardage, and this crowd in the football game.
7-0 with 2:27 in the first. Lebanon's down. Slot right. Sellers is a slot. We take it. We're back to pass. We're looking. We're looking. We're running, and Trebek gets knocked down. He may have lost back to the 24 where we got the first down to the 21, and we lost three on that play. Now they'll say he got back to the 22, lost a yard.
Bruce, we're trying to hit Rose in the flat, and I don't know if Steve got a little tied up inside, couldn't get out into his pass route. Dirksen comes into the football game, Rose comes out, and they've got a problem with the clock.
The clock won't stop, or we're checking now. 2:06 in Holliston. The referee, Mac Holliston, is over talking to the clock operator, trying to get him straightened out. The clock keeps running. Well, it stopped now momentarily at 2:06. Holliston and the clock operator having a conversation. I'm not sure who the clock operator is. Joe Ferguson, I believe, right? I'm not sure where he's from. But right now, we're second down and 10 and a half, maybe 11. We got a big first down. We're on Gallatin's 22. Green Wave are leading 7-0. Big non-district game. Oakland next week. Slot right. Trip it back to pass. Look. Long pass to DeMont. In the end zone. Touchdown. Give him 6. Touchdown. DeMont Stone. Touchdown. Blow down.
John, down on the field. They ran the fade. One-on-one coverage. DeMont wins the jump ball.
Tom, words cannot describe how beautiful that pass was. He threw it basically up for DeMond to go get, and DeMond went and got it, came down for the score. This crowd's going nuts.
1:45, snapback, Presley's kick, long and high, and we're tied at 7, and we'll be back in 30 seconds.
Punt goes 33 yards in only 6 plays. DeMond Stone, a 23-yard touchdown reception from Greg Triplett. Jonathan Presley with the extra point. 1:45 left in the first quarter. It's tied 11-7, Gallatin 7.
7-7, and we're still in the first quarter. We've got to hang on now, and this is going to be a battle, people. The stands are full on both sides. Lebanon crowds up. Presley's going to kick off. McMurray and Hall are deep. No, it's 26. I'll get his number in a minute or his name. Here comes Presley, and the kick will go line drive style, and it'll roll to the spine, to the 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, McMurray, 35, 40, 42. McMurray's dangerous everywhere. He ran that football from the 5 to the 42 and got his team in great field position. It was a line drive kick. McMurray took it on one op. They'll put it on the 41. Ball on the 41. Gallatin's got a slot left with a split right, split left in. Lasseter to the quarterback, takes it and runs McMurray up the middle, and he takes people with him for 5, 6, 7 yards and got to the 47 or 8. McMurray, a great runner and only a junior.
Bruce,
7 yards.
McMurray gets it done. Gallatin likes to zone block, just block areas, let Inman lead up the middle. And let McMurray pick his hole. It's worked so far this season. 1,012 yards coming into this game.
Ball is on the 48. They started on the 41. They're 2nd and 3. 3.5. Splitting in this away in a wing to the right and taking in run McMurray. And he's got a big hole and he got a yard. He got 3 yards. He had a big hole, but somebody closed it down pretty good. He's short of a first down by about a half a yard.
Marlowe C. on the tackle. As Lebanon trying to fill that hole when the guard doubles down, and there comes the officials out. I guess they're going to measure. John, down on the sideline, are we going to try to make some kind of defensive adjustment? Have the coaches been talking with the defense when the offense was on the field?
They've got to stand McMurray up so somebody else can get a hand on him. It's going to obviously take more than just one Blue Devil to bring that guy down. And the coaches are telling them, get a lick on him early, get him stood up, give some other people some time to get some licks in on him. But he's definitely the best runner we'll ever face.
Well, he was that way last year, and he can only improve. through. He's a junior. He's put a man wide to the left. They're third down, and the clock says 30 seconds. They're trying to wind the clock. Clock operator having difficulty tonight. Take it, quarterback sneak. He pounded in there, but I'm not sure he got it. Where he's going to spot it, he did get it. I'm not sure we got a real good spot on that. Galton got a better one. I think he got a first down. Lester and a quarterback sneak. Now they mack it up. I'm not sure it's there. John, what do you got down there? Is it there or not?
That's going to be a fourth down. Fourth down and about a foot.
He didn't get it. The clock has run out. The first quarter is over. By the clock, it's over. And let's see what we're going to do here first. It's fourth down and a foot, and I think the first quarter over. We'll only take a 30-second break, Donnie, because the first quarter is over. Back in 30 seconds.
7-7 is the score as we are now in the second quarter. Gallatin has taken a timeout. So, Donnie, we will send it back to you once again for another 30-second break as we're ready for the start of the second quarter. Gallatin takes a timeout. The score, 7-7. Field. It is fourth down and about 12 inches for a first. Tony Cantrell is raising his arms. He wants that crowd up as it's fourth and one, less than one for the Green Wave.
You got to watch the count on two, or you got to watch the quick, solid count. Gallatin to the line. They need a half. They take it and they run it and they got it. And McMurray got five and he got six and he got to the 41. He almost broke it, people. He got 9 yards in first down. He got 8 yards in the first down to our 41. We had only one man back there to knock him down. Once he went through the line, it was daylight. They'll actually say his knee touching on a 42.
Bruce, during the week of practice, the Blue Devils have worked Jade Sellers in that secondary some, not for pass coverage, but for run support, wanting to try to get another physical body up to tackle McMurray.
Slot, I set. Lester, quarterback, takes it. Runs up the middle, option, we hit him. He got a yard, he got 2 yards. Went to the 40, got knocked down on a 40. Maybe got to the 39. Oh, they'll put it back on the 40, give him two, second and eight. Lester running a counter option that time and got two, and it's second and eight.
That defensive secondary for the Blue Devils, Ivan Reeves in the secondary at strong safety, Mo Thompson, Zach Manier, the corners, Damon Stone, All-State last year as a junior, back there as the free safety.
Hall will split wide to the right. Slot right. Lester takes it back to pass, looking over the middle. He dropped it, incomplete. Lester was being pressured by Tony Cantrell to pass. The Hall was covered by Mo Thompson on a 30, incomplete. Lester, Tommy, looks like he's put on a lot of weight since last year. He's a short, stocky guy, and I think he's added 10 or 15 pounds.
Bruce, they list him at 5'9". My people over in Gallatin tell me he's closer to 5'7". He's about 180 pounds. He's a thick little quarterback, and he's one of the best we've got in the mid-state.
Slot eye. Third down and eight, back to pass, fake the draw. Looking, got a man wide open on the 30, first down. Gallatin on the 30 as he curled a man down there, number 40 for Gallatin was Ashley Brooks, and he caught it on the 30 and got a first down. They'll put it on the 31. First down, Lester, like you said, he just simply drilled that football in there.
There are probably better quarterbacks. There are probably better arms, better runners at the quarterback position, but a guy that puts the whole package together with leadership and play faking, that's Lassiter from Gallatin.
All comes out here wide to the right. Lassiter takes it, drops back, runs a draw to McMurray, and he got 2, 3, 4 yards. As he crossed the 30, got to the 27, I believe they'll put it on, and got four, and it's second and six. This guy's just hard to stop. Gallatin throws a lot of weapons at you.
What do they do, Bruce, when you think the wide receiver, Hall, has 18 receptions for 400-something yards? He's averaging 24 yards every time he catches the football from Lassiter. Lassiter's averaging over 20.